Hello and welcome back to the channel. I'm Vinny, Mr. G, UK reseller, and today I'll be showing you what I picked up at a Carboot sale. Now it's been a few weeks since I've actually popped a video out. I have been doing quite a lot of filming in store, but I haven't managed to put any sort of video together. The shop's been really busy. I've been getting disturbed quite a lot by jobs and customers, which is always good because it means we're busy, but I haven't been able to put anything together for you. So that's why I haven't been around for a few weeks. But today I woke up, it's Sunday. My wife said to me, do you fancy doing a car boot or going to a car boot to have a look around because it's nice weather? I was like, sure, I haven't done a car boot this season. We just have too much stock, really. So we went over to a car boot in Truro. There was about 100 cars there. It started at 12, like midday. Got there about 10 minutes early. There was tons and tons of people there. Horn goes off. Everyone runs in and goes mental. But for me, it was a little bit different today because I was just having a look around. And if anything took my fancy, I was going to buy it. So I was really only looking for like sort of like really good purchases today, but there wasn't really any there. So I settled for some smaller purchases. And in this video, I'm going to tell you kind of why I bought them, my thinking behind it, and what I think I might be able to sell this stuff for, whether it be in the shop or on eBay. Some of the stuff in this video is not going to be good if you're just doing eBay. If you have a store, I'll tell you the reasons behind why I bought them and what I paid for them. So if you've managed to stay with me for this long, which is only a short amount of time, please remember to leave a like and a subscribe. It really helps the channel and we really appreciate it. If you also want to leave a comment down below about anything in the video, do that and stay tuned because we're going to show you what we bought next. So I managed to spend a whopping £27 today. Wow. Without further ado, I'll tell you what I bought. A few weeks ago on my Instagram, you may have seen me post some stuff about Squishmallows. Here's a picture. Mainly because of the clownfish named Ricky, but also because actually these ones, these keyring ones, had quite a bit of value. So I was keeping my eye open for those around the car boot anyway. One of the first stalls I came to actually had some mini Squishmallows. These little things, tags are actually bigger than them. These are called Squishville. They're by Squishmallow. I've never seen these small ones before. I didn't see these while I was researching the other ones. There's quite a few at the stall. There was six in total. I saw them in a bag and I thought, are they worth a go? But I also noticed this narwhal. This is a squishable. I don't know if that's the same company. I don't think it is. So I grabbed him, asked how much the lady wanted for this. She said £1. I thought, okay, that can go in the cabinet if it's not worth very much. I thought maybe between 5 and 10. But for £1 into 5, 10, that's great in the shop. I also noticed this. This was also squishy. This is a squeeze-em-all. So another brand, I assume. This is just a unicorn. Needs a bit of a wash. It's a little bit grubby. I paid £1 for this and I thought, again, maybe £5 to £10 in the shop. If I then go home and find out it's worth more, I can stick it on eBay. I've done a bit of research on these and we're about right, £5 to £10 and sort of like £8 to £10. So they can go in the store. We can probably get 13 back for that £2 spend. I also saw this on the stall, this big Squishmallow. Now this is a Squishmallow. This is a cheetah pattern. Can't remember what the name of this one was. But most of these bigger sort of jumbo squish-em-alls, anywhere between £20 and £40, some of them do command a higher price. I've seen some in the hundreds. Whether they're selling or not, I don't know. But they're well worth a shout. This one needs a bit of a wash as well. He's a little bit grubby, but I think we could probably stick this on eBay and get an easy £20 to £40 for this. If it's a rarer one or an older one, we might even be able to ask 50, 60 plus. But we'll have to see. Haven't done any research on this guy. So this cost me £2. So 2 into potentially 40, that'll be great. 2 into 20, that'll be fine. 20 in the shop will be okay as well. I think he's more likely to sell on eBay. And then we can just put him away. I have room in my cabinets at the store, but probably not this much room at the moment. But I thought that was worth a go for £2. If she'd have said £5 or £6, I probably would have passed on that. Back to these guys. I noticed under some clothes on the stall, there was a big box of Roblox toys. Cars, figures, bits and bobs. This whole box is just literally full of Roblox stuff. A couple of the crates. Now, I had some of these Roblox ages ago. I sold a couple and got about a tenner each just for a figure. So I was like, okay, there could potentially be some good money in here. I know some of them are worth an awful lot of money, like £100 for just one Roblox figure, especially if you get a special one. Now, I don't know if any of these are special ones, but I said to the woman, how much do you want for this whole box of Roblox? And she said, I want £5. And I was like, you know what, it's probably worth it at a fiver. I could probably list all of this and get £20 on eBay. I do little bundles of like Fortnite figures. They generally go for £20. Little bundles of like toys. Like I had loads of Minion figures. They went for like £20. And you can generally pick up a bag for like £3 or £4 and then turn it into 20, which is reasonable, I'd say. 20 plus postage at least. And then, so I was like, five's fine, but if we can get it lower, that's even better. I was like, would you do £3 for the lot? She was like, how about £4? And I was like, okay, yeah, okay, that'd be fine. How about £5 with these? Because I was assuming she might ask like 50p each for these, or maybe £1 each, or maybe £2. I don't know. So I thought for a fiver for that lot, that's probably okay. These ones, I've done a little bit of research on these. It looks like a bundle of them, you can get about £15 to £20. Some of them are like £5 each. Some of them come in sets. I haven't found these ones in, or I haven't found these ones specifically, but I found similar ones. And the little bundles seem to go from £15 to £20. Some of them go much higher. So I need to do a little bit of research on those. I need to research all these Roblox figures as well, just make sure there's nothing expensive in there. But I reckon that's probably an easy £5 into £30, maybe £40, maybe even £50 for that lot. We will see. So not too bad so far. Most of that is off one stall. Oh, and also she had one of these as well. Now, I remember Ricky Lee showing on one of his videos a long time ago, a horse that looked very similar to this. I don't think it was this one. It could have been. I was definitely thinking of leaving this behind, but I just remember seeing it on his video and I was like, if this is worth money and I don't pick it up, I'm going to be annoyed with myself. I didn't really want to stand there and scan it. I asked her how much she wanted for it. She said £1. So I thought, well, I'll take a gamble on that. Turns out, I don't know if this is the one that was on Ricky's thing. Turns out these are worth about a tenner now. So probably not worth really picking up. I could probably stick this on eBay for £8 plus postage and it will probably sell pretty quickly. So yeah, a bit of a flop on that one, but not a big deal because it was only £1. I could just take it down the charity shop and donate it. We'll see how we feel. So I might get that listed today. I might try and get most of this listed today, actually. I also saw a few little figures that I picked up as well, including this Star Wars Moroff, I think it's called. This is from Hasbro. It's Rogue One, so it's a lot later, I think, than the original stuff. And also this Monster in My Pocket, which would have been from about 1993, let's say. I paid 20p for this. I paid 50p for this. This one's worth about £6. This one's worth about £3, but they can just go in my cabinet and hopefully someone will pick those up. In fact, our cabinets have been picking up pretty well recently. Lots of people coming in and grabbing bits out of them. So they are getting quite empty again. They do need a refill. I also saw this guy, and initially I thought he might be a visionary when I saw him at the bottom of the box. Lights in the magical light. Turns out he's not. I picked him out. He's Chat May. The little boy was really polite, so give him a quid for this. I think it probably makes sound. It's from 1998. People are asking about £7 for this. I'd probably stick it in the cabinet for £3 or £4 and make a little bit of profit on that, but nothing major. I also have some toy boxes in the shop now that I'm putting toys into bags and just selling them at £2, £3 each. So I might even just stick him in there. So nothing major there. Just was a bit excited because I thought he might be a visionary to start with. Another one which I wouldn't recommend picking up is Jumanji, the board game. I think this used to have quite a good price mark on it though. The reason I picked it up was because she only wanted a pound. I had in my mind that the price on these had dropped, but I thought for a pound, I can have that in the shop and people can play it. That was my thinking behind that one. Instructions are included. Contents, one game board, four coloured pawns, one rhino mover, one sand timer, missing, two dice, four rescue dice and 33 danger cards, one instruction manual. That's all there. The timer is missing. However, I often buy random board games that have lots of bits in, so I do have spare timers, loads of dice and things like that, counters at the shop in a box. So I'll grab one of the timers and then that'll be complete. If you really wanted to sell this, you could probably get about £8 plus postage for this on eBay. Might be a bit of a slow seller though. I'm going to keep that for the shop and let people use that, because at the end of the day, it cost me a pound. I could even rent it out for a pound a go and then make some money on it. So I'll probably do something like that, like a little renty board game section where you can just rent games out for a pound. It doesn't then matter if this gets absolutely wrecked, even after one use, because I make my pound back. But let's hope people are good with it. So anyway, there's that. Stay away from Jumanji unless you've got a shop where you can rent it out for a pound a go or something. Ertl, Esky, Prussian Infantry, 172 scale. I always pick stuff like this up because some of it can have some really good value, especially if it's cheap. The lady said this was complete. There's supposed to be 50 figures in there. I'm not sure there will be, but I can show you later on my Instagram. 50 figures, £1. I reckon that's an easy £15 to £20. I haven't done any research on it, but I reckon an easy £15 to £20. Maybe more because it's Ertl, I'm not sure. Need to do a bit more research on that, but for £1, I was definitely going to pick that up. Also picked up this Pepper Army Fanimal. I believe there's two, a red and a white one. There may be more. I've got both already in my cabinet. Lots of people ask if they're for sale. I always tell them no. Now I have one that's for sale. You give them a slap and then they, I'm an animal. About up to £20 for these if they're working. Just check that they're not too badly ripped there. This one has been stretched a little bit. But what I'm thinking is if this one doesn't work, I'll put this one in my cabinet and then sell the one in my cabinet that does work. I'm not really that special about keeping this. It's just like, because it worked and I had one, I thought I may as well. Sometimes they come with a scarf. Keep an eye out for that because you can ask more. And if they're sealed, then you can probably ask a bit more, maybe up to £35. I think there may be an American market for these because I don't think they had these. They had something else. Someone said on my Instagram. But if you've got GSP on, if an American wants to buy it, they'll grab that quickly. So there we go. That cost me £2. So two, probably another two into £15, £20. So not big money, but just some money. You have to remember that I wasn't really going as a reseller, but that you can't take the buying out of a reseller. So I was always going to buy something. Next up, I saw this Funko Pop. Now, I'm not a huge collector of Funko Pops. I know some people have hundreds. I probably have about 20, maybe 30. And most of them are collectible ones or vaulted now because I started at the beginning. However, now I just kind of pick up ones I like the look of. This one was on the floor. She wanted £5, but I didn't really want to pay £5 for it. When I picked it up, though, it was really heavy. It's like probably the heaviest Funko Pop I've ever picked up. So I thought, weight-wise, he's probably worth the fiver, and he's pretty cool, and I kind of liked him, but I didn't really want to spend a fiver on him. However, here's another thing you can do at Carboot if you feel like it. She had these two sitting next to it, and she said she wanted a fiver each, so that'd be 15 for the lot. I said, how about 10 for the lot? She said, what about 12? And I was like, I'm happy on 10 if you'll do 10. That way I can get this one and then I can sell these two to pay for this one. So I'm probably not going to make any profit on this, but what I am going to do is I'm going to get this for free, technically. So I did some research on these two guys. It looks like they're about a tenner each. So £11.99 posted, I believe. And maybe £10 plus postage I've seen these for. So I can probably stick these on eBay for £20, make my money back, pay my fees, pay my VAT, and probably make a couple of pounds on top. I could probably stick those in the shop for £15 as well. That way I can sell them, cover my VAT, and then I get this for free. Probably make a couple of pounds. So I might stick them in the shop at £15 for the pair and on eBay for £20 the pair plus postage. And then this one's going to go in my collection. So hopefully he'll be free. So that's just another thing you can do if you're at a car boot. Just try and make things you want free. We also picked up this, the Vikings game. This is complete. Again, not huge money, but I paid £2 for this. And I'll probably see a return of £20 to £25 on eBay. I could probably stick that in my shop and ask for £15 if I wanted a quick sale. I'll probably stick it on eBay and try that. I might put it in the shop as well if there's room on the game board rack. And that is it. That's everything I bought. If you've managed to stick around for that 14 minutes, well done. Please remember to leave a like and a subscribe if you haven't already. Join the crew, be part of the reselling community if you're not already. You can find me on Instagram as well. I post a lot of pictures and stuff on there of things we buy and sell. So head on over to Instagram if you haven't already as well. But first, watch the rest of this video to see what I think I can get for everything in total. So I've totted it up. We're looking at 20 for this. Probably 20 for this, that's 40. 15. 55, 10, 65, 20 for the Roblox, 85, 10 for these, 95, say 10 for this, 105, and let's say 15 for these, so that's £120. So 130 from £25. That seems reasonable to me. You know, spending like £27 is what we spent. And turning it into £130, that's very low end, I think. Obviously, I think we could probably get up to 40 for the big squishimal. Probably 25 for the Vikings. There's this as well, which we might be able to get 8 to 10 quid for. Probably these, which we can get a tenner for, the pair. Someone might buy this for £2 or £3. And all of those little bits add up. So I think for a little outing to the car boot, that wasn't too bad. The other thing I bought was actually the biggest steal of the day for me, was 400... sealed air padded envelopes. Well, I had a few on me. The boxes they came in were pretty wrecked, pretty squashed. But I picked up 400 of these. I have had to chuck a couple away because the boxes were quite soiled and whatever was on them had gone through and damaged some of the envelopes, but maybe about 5. So I got 395 of these. And a big roll of bubble wrap. I said to the guy, how much do you want for all your padded envelopes? And he said, well, I was hoping to get £30. And I was like, you know what? That's actually still quite a good deal, I think, compared to what you can buy on eBay. But I wasn't really wanting to spend £30. It was the first thing I saw at the boot sale as well. And I was like, nah, I'm going to leave that. And he was like, well, tell me what your price is then. So I said a cheeky tenner. I said, I don't know what the envelopes are like inside. They've probably lost their stickiness. I don't care about that. I'll just sellotape them. But the boxes were damaged. So I said, you know, some of them might be damaged inside. And rather than open them and have a look, he was like, how about 15? So I was like, yeah, sure. And then I said, I'll take the bubble wrap as well. And he was like, that's just £1 for a big roll of bubble wrap. So I was like, okay, that's cool. Because the bubble wrap normally is quite expensive, as you probably know. And the padded envelopes, I had a look on eBay and it looks like you can get 500 for about £80 of this size and this colour of this brand. So I was like, okay, that's cool. You know, we paid £15, £16 for probably like £50 to £70 worth of envelopes. So that was really good. So they will just go on our little spreadsheet when we... So basically every time we go to a car boot, we do a little spreadsheet. Just handwritten, we write the car boot, the time, the date, how much we spent on products to resell, how much we spent on stuff to use in store. So office equipment, this will be. So we spent £16 on office equipment or packing materials. And then we spent £27 on stuff to resell. So yeah, that's it. That's another video. I'm sorry it took 3 weeks to do a video. I'm not going to promise that I'll do anytime soon, but I will try and put something together and keep an eye on my Instagram because there's tons of pictures going on there because they're really easy to do. If you fancy watching any more of my videos, here's a couple here that I think you might like. If you've watched these ones, I've got quite a lot of videos, probably over 50 different videos you can watch. Just be aware that some of those were recorded quite some time ago, so prices may have changed, they may have gone up, so they might be worth a watch. I'm currently at 1,200 view hours into my YouTube channel. I need to get to 4,000. Please watch the videos. I think you might find them useful. Thanks for watching. See you soon on the channel.